Hello and welcome back, guys, to a brand new episode on 100% free to play. We are back on Wizard101 playing our death character. Today we're going to go and checking out what's going on with Diego, and we were sent to Old Town by Professor Ambrose, Headmaster. And so let's get right into it. We have talked to Doodle here. She's our student advisor, I believe. So let's see what she has to say.
Oh, wow! You look new! Are you new here? Have you met all the professors? Have you picked a school? Oh, have you tried electives?
You see what I'm saying? First off, she's wearing pink. That's new. Does it have hearts on it? I think it does. I wonder if that's a thing too. I wonder if the new, if I go to make a new character now, if you don't pick your school immediately anymore. I wonder if, like, the new update changed it. We'll have to find out when we make a new character again.
You've gotta try electives. They're a great break from dueling, and you can get all sorts of great things from them.
Okay.
Oh, you just have to let me show you around Wizard City and all the amazing things you can do here.
Amazing. Sweet.
Follow me outside.
Let's get a tour.
This is a side quest. By default, your quest arrow will continue pointing you toward your next main story objective. To have it point to this quest's goal, press Q, then select the City Tour quest. Once this quest is complete, the arrow will point to the main quest again.
Sweet. So we press Q, and we'll head over to the City Tour.
Is the Commons, a gathering place for wizards of all schools and skill levels. It's also where you learn to... Wait for it.
I'm waiting.
Fish!
Oh.
I know! We can fish here! With magic! Just talk to old Lucky Hookline to learn all about it.
Alright, we'll have to do a fishing episode.
That's right. Fishing's a great way to find unique items. You can even get aquariums to display your best catches from all over the spiral.
Heck yeah.
And if you're planning on traipsing all over that there spiral, give your feet a rest with a mount. It'll really speed up your exploring.
This is true.
You should talk to old Zeke whenever you see him. And I swear I see him everywhere. You get training points for helping him. And this is Eloise. She can stitch your gear so you can upgrade it, but keep your style the same. Now let's move on.
Yeah, these two are in every world. They're always there. He has you going searching for little items everywhere. Well, creatures, little tiny creatures. And she's there to help you if you ever want to change your clothes. So pretty much if you like an outfit, how it looks, but you like the stats of this outfit, you can pay crowns to stitch those buffs onto the outfit you actually like. So you can pretty much wear like the basic wizard outfit, or pretty much, right? But have really high stats on it, and so people think you're a noob. It would just be kind of funny. Alright, where to next? We have to go to Golem Court now. Person has a pumpkin on their head. Look at all these ghosts and ghouls.
This is Golem Court. This place is brimming with excitement. Sometimes, I hear, evil necromancers attack this place. And sometimes, nothing does.
How's that? Talking about Maladar.
And, oh, there's Farley, the Wizard City Gardener. That's exciting, too.
gardening is indeed exciting. You can raise crops in your dorm or house that yield all kinds of items to aid you in your journey.
Yeah, so you can actually garden. I talked about gardening in the last episode. You can actually garden by just putting it into pots. But that red barn that I showed you in the last episode, they actually have plots already made for you to garden in. But you can farm in any house.
Gardens also make for prettier landscapes, perfect for my specialty, photomancy, magical portrait making which lets you preserve still images.
Still images. Selfies.
I know, right? There's so much to do here, and we're not even done. But let's take a quick breath, inhale, exhale, and get back to basics. Because when it really comes down to it, almost everything you do makes you better at dueling. So let's go meet the duel master.
Ooh, I gotta go talk to him anyway. So we could pull some quests from these guys, but I'll do that later. Just 'cause we'll do one little area at a time. All right, so we're gonna head back to Unicorn Way, and the duel arena is pretty cool. So you can actually challenge other wizards around here to a battles, and they have tournaments, and you can actually win some pretty good tickets, which gets you some pretty good gear. But like PvP is its own beast; it is like its own separate thing. There's like
wizard,
regular.
Allow me to introduce the Ravenwood Duel Master.
So yeah, there's like actual like PvP like battles just out in the streets or whatever. Like, well, not PvE, I guess. So just battling the creatures, that's completely different, because like you're fighting a computer. They're not as like trying to be like doing strategy. You're kind of doing strategy, but when you get into PvP, you're going against two people that are trying to strategize against each other. So it just gets even crazier. It goes down to this type of gear you're wearing, to the type of pet you have, to the type of cards you're using, the treasure cards, and it gets nuts. I am nowhere near ready for that, but eventually I'm going to do a series and try to get to that level.
Diego Santiago Corrigues Ramirez III at your service, young wizard. Abby tells me you wish to learn of the arena, yes?
Crazy.
Ah, but the arena, she is not for the faint of heart. She holds a contest like no other, where wizards duel one another. Not enter unprepared.
Unprepared. This is true.
Oh, don't worry about that, because the next stop on our tour is the shopping district, where you can prepare for anything.
By spending money. Alright, we'll head over there. And then I guess, I don't know if we'll actually have time to talk to the duel master. We have Halloween quest. Maybe we should do that.
Here is your go-to source for anything you might need. Wands, robes, pointy hats. It's all here.
So yeah, pretty cool. You see this mirror right here that helps you change your appearance. This paint right here allows you to like dye your clothes differently, and maybe even some pets, I can't remember. So yeah, that's cool. You have where you can buy some wizard hats and pets. A little further down there's where you can buy houses.
You can also get better card decks, pet supplies, furniture for your dorm, new houses and jewels. Or visit the magic mirror to change your look.
Maybe I should just let you talk. I apologize.
If your gear lacks a little something, this is the first place you should come to improve it. But if you're light on gold, just come this way.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's a really cool little area over here. We got Spooky Bob here today. He's selling a bunch of spooky gear, but they cost crowns. You got rings that give you extra power, where you can buy some decks and new houses. What else is that? Yeah, the furniture, boots, and everything. But honestly, it's you're better off just going straight to the bazaar, which we're going to be heading to next. Because there you can kind of sell your own items and get really good gear. These stores only really give you the basics.
So you're a young student. You don't have all the gold in the world. I know what that's like. But you still need gear. Because, you know, monsters. That's why you come to Old Town's Bazaar, run by Mr. Alex Silverfist.
There he is. Why aren't you running the store right now?
Yep, that's me. If you have items you don't need, just come to me to put them up for auction so that other wizards can buy them from you.
I don't think I've ever heard your voice before.
Alex Bazaar is a great way to turn all your non-school gear and things into gold. But another way to get good gear is to just make it.
This is true.
Ah, yes. There's nothing more satisfying than a magic wand you carved yourself. Come see me when you're ready to learn the fine art of crafting.
And I, think that ends the tour? I know, it's so sad. But now you know you can fish, craft, auction, duel, garden, walk, and, something else. Photomance! I knew I was forgetting something. Oh, and buy stuff! You can do that, too. Anyway, hope you love the tour. See you around, wizard.
I like how they walk away and they kind of fade out. That's actually a really good ad. So yeah, you can actually craft a lot of your items, too. So, like, you want to save some money. I mean, at the end of the day, though, it sometimes costs a lot to, like, it's a lot of work. I haven't found a way to really use it and make money out of it, but mainly because I'm too lazy. Because it's like, when you get to the high-tier gear that you want, you have to make the low-tier gear and then, like, keep, like, adding to it. And I end up just buying the low-tier gear to make it right away, so I kind of lose money in the end. But, yeah, that's a good way right here to actually just, like, get your gear made yourself. You don't shop, you don't do nothing. Maybe one day I'll do something like that, little only crafting. But yeah, there's a bazaar. We don't really need to go in there, I don't believe. We need to talk to Sergeant. Let's not talk to Sergeant. Let's head over and here's a quick little teleport to the commons. Yeah. We'll go talk to Diego since he yelled at us earlier to come over. And I swear if he tells me to come back at level 10, I'm going to be very upset because he told me to come. We're level 5. Floating, everybody has the cards.
Aha! Hello there, my friend.
Hello.
Headmaster Ambrose has asked me to show you more of the art of dueling, no?
I don't know, did he?
Most excellent. This will take but a few minutes. Enter the door to the arena to begin.
Okay. What's this?
Greetings, young wizard. I am Diego, the duel master. You have heard of the illustrious wizard versus wizard duels, yes? Any wizard can duel another wizard in the arena, either in a practice duel or a ranked duel.
So I feel like they updated him already. So like this sounds like an old quest, like his old voice. And the other one was like a little higher, a little louder, a little different. So I think it was like a little better quality as well. I think that they just didn't change this one.
And once you reach level 10, you will be able to compete in proper tournaments. To duel another wizard, you must first enter the arena. Go inside and look at the arena pedestals. Then come back to me.
Alright, so let's go inside here. I don't know if we can do all that. I think it might...
Welcome, my friend, to the dueling arena.
Hello.
You wish to learn more of the art of dueling, no?
No.
Outstanding. Approach the puppet, and we shall begin your lesson.
Time to battle. Duel.
Let us begin by explaining power points. You may call them pips for short.
Where did the eye come from?
Power points are magical energy. Gaining peeps allows you to cast more powerful spells.
I feel like they call it pips because it's very unfortunate just to keep the two first letters.
Every round, you will receive another pip. You can see the number of pips each participant has by looking at the circle around their feet.
Okay.
Nearly every card has a pip cost. It is the number in the upper left-hand corner, yes?
Mm-hmm.
You can only cast a spell if you have enough pips to do so.
See, they snuck it in there. It says, and mana.
Let us start with one spell with a pip cost of 2. But you only have one pip, so you cannot cast this turn. You will have to pass.
It will pass.
You can also use a 0-rank spell if you want to save up power pips. Good! You have passed and gained another pip. With 2 pips, you can now cast the troll spell. Ah, but look! You have drawn another card. Tough. This is an enchantment card.
These cards are really cool.
Enchantment cards can be used to improve the other cards in your hand. Let me show you. Click on the tough card.
So yeah, so you grab this card, and it's going to add 75 attack to one of your spells.
And
so
now click on the troll. Look what has happened. The card has been enchanted to do more damage. Now it is a treasure card.
This, I swear, Wizard101, why don't you have a card game? This would be amazing. This is a card game. Get the cards made. Everybody will buy and collect all of those.
Unused treasure cards go back into your deck at the end of the duel. Now, since you have 2 pips, you can cast the troll at the puppet.
If I get 1 million subscribers one day, I'll make my own card game. You guys can hold me to that.
Now you are back to 1 pip, yes?
Yes.
Let us give you another hand. With only 1 pip, you cannot cast any of these third rank spells. You will need to pass for 2 rounds. But wait! There's another way. Let me show you. I've given you a power pip. See?
See.
At the beginning of each round, you will have a chance to get a power pip instead of a normal pip. Power pips count double, but only for spells in your class. Now you have 1 pip and 1 power pip. That means you can cast any second rank spell that you wish. Or you can use a third rank spell in your school of focus. 1 point for the pip, plus 2 points for the power pip.
This is really good training.
See? The card for your school is now available to you. Cast it at the puppet now.
So yeah, like he said, double yellow means power, and it's a double power pit.
Outstanding! Now let us look at another type of spell card. A ward can be used to protect you against future attacks. This is a fire ward. When you cast it on someone, it will hang in front of them, waiting to be activated. The next incoming fire spell will trigger it. Let me show you. Cast this fire ward upon yourself. Very good! See how this fire ward hangs near your feet? Watch how it can protect you.
Negative 80. That's a good one. This normally hits like maybe a 160.
The fire ward has activated and helps you resist most of the damage from this attack. Let's try one more hanging spell. This one is called Ice Blade. Cast it on yourself and see what happens.
So you got blades, right? So blades stack. Shields protect.
Charms are the opposite of wards. Wards affect spells that other people cast on you. Charms affect spells that you cast on other people. Cast this frost beetle at the puppet. Let's see how the charm works. Do you see?
Your ice beetle has triggered the ice charm. Now the ice beetle is more powerful.
It wasn't that powerful.
Now let us cover one more type of hanging effect. The aura spells. Aura spells affect a target over multiple rounds of combat. For example, the fire elf spell will cost 240 points of fire damage spread over 3 rounds.
Yeah, so like we were talking about with the fire school, they like their slow burning effect, right?
Let's see how it works. Cast a fire elf at the puppet.
Attacks him every round. And so.
Good! Now watch what happens next round.
Attack.
And again?
See, this is really
excellent.
Good training that needs to be
done. You have defeated him and completed your lesson. I hope you have found our lesson to be most helpful. Good luck, my friend, and see you soon.
So yeah, that was really good training. I think we could do that exit for us. And then we'll head back in there. We have one more quest in there. So yeah, that training was really good, especially for early game. And so we got to learn all of these. All of these people are in here. They're all trying to battle each other and doing a tournament probably.
The tournament pass, though, will let you join tournaments, but you must reach level 10 before you can use it.
There's people, level 10, right? So powerful that they can beat level hundreds. Like, they can stand toe-to-toe with them, which is crazy, because what they do is actually figure out who they're battling, right? So, say they're death. And they wear everything that'll help them beat them. Like, they have specific sets for everything, which is crazy.
You can win special prizes by competing in tournaments. I will tell you more about them when you are ready.
So, yeah, this game has so many, like, little wide things you can do to keep yourself busy and have fun.
To compete as a ranked duelist, click on the ranked pedestal to create a challenge. Or to accept another wizard's challenge.
So I feel like this area right here is probably where people stay the most. Because, yeah, it's just... there's just so much to do in just this one spot. And it makes you strong.
You have the chance to win arena tickets, which you can redeem for prizes. And every win will increase your PvP rating. However, if you lose or flee a duel, your PvP rating will go down.
Crazy.
The leaderboard pedestal allows you to see your standings. It shows you how your rating compares to other duelists. Each season of Wizard versus Wizard duels is known as an age. The length of an age is something of a mystery. Every time a new age begins, the leaderboard standings are annulled to give every wizard another chance to shine.
Oh, so they refresh the leaderboard. That's cool. I guess we can look at it too. Oh, we're in the fourth age. And right now, a level 50. See, look. A level 50 is rank 1. A level 10 is rank 2. A level 2. Okay, I don't know if they're actually... is that? There's no way it's a level 2. So maybe that's level 2 PvP. But look at, like, you can see all the wins. I would have... it won't tell me. Yeah, there's no way. That has to be their PvP ranking. I was going to say level 2. But yeah, like, you could work your way up quickly in that. I don't think it wants us to know that one.
You can simply click on the practice pedestal to create a duel or to accept another wizard's challenge. Practice tools are not recorded and do not affect your PvP rating, but they are a fantastic way to hone your skills.
Yeah, this is the one way. Because you do kind of have to pay to play the PvP. Everybody pretty much puts their money in the pot, and winners take all. So yeah, that was pretty cool. We learned a lot today in this episode. That was really awesome. The next one, we still got to go talk to Sergeant Mudum in Old Town to figure out what's going on in the other towns. So, I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys. Boop!